Yeah, I'm sorry too. I guess I should have told you what was wrong with me. But Mom and Dad weren't telling anyone except family, so I... How come you stopped being my friend? I don't know. I mean, actually, I think I do. This is going to sound ridiculous, but I was jealous.
What? You were jealous of me? You wanted to be sick?
Of course not, but you were getting so much attention from the teachers. Everyone always asking how you felt and giving you extensions on your assignments, and you got to miss a ton of school. Lainey, I missed so much. I nearly had to repeat the sixth grade. Are you serious? I didn't know. Well, I didn't know that. Well, remember Bobby Reader? He thought you were contagious. For some reason, I believed him. Since I was your best friend, I was positive I was going to get it, whatever it was.
Oh. When my parents found out about our fight, they were pretty mad at me and talked to me about it. I didn't know how to apologize to you. And that's why I never wrote you after you moved away.
Well, I was pretty mad. But I guess it would have helped if I told you the truth.
You know, now and then, I wonder about the people here.
Like who?
Well, I remember Desire Dunlop. How she used to brag she was the first in our class to outgrow her training bra.
Did she?
Yes, and the day she came in wearing her new bra, Lowell Johnston asked her out on a date. No way!
Stacy, look.
The movie's over.
Wow, we missed the whole thing.
Yeah.
It was worth it, though. Lainey and I realized we had a lot of catching up to do, so we made the most of the weekend. And when we went to sleep on Sunday night, I felt like a huge weight had been lifted from my chest.
Night, Nanny. Night, Stacy.
Well, two, actually. Hello, Dr. Barnes. Yes, I'm sorry, but we've decided to cancel the rest of Stacy's test this week.
And then we were home.
Stace! Hi, Claude! Oh, we missed you so much. What a crazy weekend. We have to tell you everything.
Jamie and Charlotte and the other kids told their parents everything. You should have been there. You should have seen Liz and Michelle's faces today during... Wait, how was New York?
It was good. Really, really good. But tell me more about what happened.
Well, we should probably wait until Christy and Marianne get there before... Bring!
I'll get it!
Babysitter's Club.
Hi, Mrs. Newton.
Hello, Stacy.
Oh, hi!
I've got a meeting at the literary circle at my house on Friday. At my house on Friday afternoon, and I need someone to watch Lucy and keep Jamie busy for a couple of hours. Can you do it?
I'll do it. What time?
3:00. And I'd like you to know, I had a talk with Kathy Morris, and I think she honestly didn't realize what she did was wrong. I also called the Johnsons, the Pikes, the Jimaricos, and the Dodsons. It turns out Jamie and Charlotte weren't the only unhappy children. I want you to know that I'm grateful how grateful we are that you girls were brave enough to tell us what was going on.
Stacy, you know you're supposed to offer every job that comes along to all the members.
I'm sorry, I forgot. I was just so excited!
I know. It's okay. I'd be pretty excited about sitting for Lucy, too. Besides, I've broken that rule often myself.
Stacy! Stacy!
The phone rang all that afternoon. At 6, we were pretty much feeling better about ourselves. I wonder if anyone will call us tonight when we're at home. Probably.
With Christmas so close, everybody's going to parties, dinners, and concerts. This may be our busiest season yet.
Do you guys think the babysitter's agency will get any more calls?
I really doubt it.
Hey, are you guys going to the snowflake dance on Friday?
Nah, why would I want to go to some dumb dance?
Oh, yeah.
Trevor Sanborn asked me.
Really? I'm going with Pete Black.
You should both come, Christy and Marianne. It's going to be so much fun.
Fun? It doesn't sound like fun.
Oh, we have to figure out what we're all wearing.
Bring, 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 bring.
Hello?
Stacy!
Hi, Lainey.
What's happening with your babysitter's club? Last week you said something about some agency?
Oh gosh, you'll never believe it. All of our clients stopped calling the babysitter's agency because they wouldn't trust the members. And then we got to school on Tuesday.
Yeah?
Liz and Michelle were handing out flyers for a new business. Join Makeovers, Inc.
Yeah, join Makeovers, Inc.
Makeovers, Inc.? You pay them $5 and they show you how to put on makeup and figure out the best way to fix up your hair.
No thanks.
Nobody seemed interested in their new scheme.
Oh, and guess what? Charlotte Johnson, the little girl who was having trouble with her classmates?
Yeah?
Her teacher is going to skip her into the third grade. The work in second grade was too easy for her. That's why the other kids were teasing her. Charlotte's really excited about starting fresh in the new year.
Oh, that's good. I really wish I could meet her. I'd love to meet all your friends there, Stacy.
Well, you could come visit in Stony Brook.
Really?
Yes, and when you do, we'll make you an honorary member of the Babysitter's Club. Thanks, everybody, for listening to my story.
Stacy, come here. They're about to drop the ball.
Oh, I have to go. It's New Year's Eve. Bye.
But you don't know what you don't know. Someday I'll be living in a big old city. Gotta be so mean.